Hi there, this is Richard Walker from Lucidate. Welcome back to this fifth video in our series on fine-tuning large language models. In previous videos, we've looked at what LLMs are, seen how we can fine-tune both local and cloud-based models, explored motivations for fine-tuning in the form of code generation, and took a close look at low-rank adaptation, or LoRA, a mechanism for optimizing fine-tuning of large language models. We're going to split this video into two parts. In the first part, we'll take a closer look at the tools Hugging Face provides for fine-tuning, specifically the pipeline and trainer APIs. Then we'll look at fine-tuning a transformer model. We'll be using a version of the BERT transformer developed by Google. We'll see how an out-of-the-box version of BERT does on simple sentiment classification, and then compare that to the performance of our fine-tune version of BERT. Stick around to the end of the video to find out how you can get your hands on all the source code for this tutorial, as well as the source code for the second video in this series. Okay, so in the previous videos, we covered the theory. Let's now get into the Hugging Face tools that make fine-tuning practical. First up, the Hugging Face pipeline. Initially, working with LLMs can seem daunting. Where do I start? What do I do? You might get directed to Hugging Face. This would indeed be a good start. But what then? There are seemingly an endless amount of models and datasets. The choice can be bewildering. The pipeline is the easiest way to get started with LLMs. Not only will it provide you with a suitable model for your task, it will handle all of the pre- and post-processing for you. Here's how it works. You can choose from a variety of natural language processing, computer vision, audio, and multimodal AI tasks. A subset of the full list is available in the table on your screen. All you need to do is supply a pipeline identifier, and Hugging Face will provide you with a default model and arrange for all of the necessary pre- and post-processing of your data. This means in just four lines of code, you can build an image classifier using an existing pre-trained model. Providing a default model, as well as all of the pre- and post-processing steps, saves a massive amount of time. It means that you can focus on your application rather than get lost in the weeds of tokenization, lowercasing, normalization, image resizing, or any of the other tasks that take the bulk of the time in AI projects. Hugging Face pipelines mean that you can quickly build your translation or image capturing tool with the minimum of fuss and effort. In this video, we'll be focusing on the first element in this table, sentiment analysis, but head over to Hugging Face and try out some of the other out-of-the-box pipeline types to see how easy it is to use Hugging Face pipelines. Try out this code sample. In just four lines of code, we can set up an LLM to perform sentiment analysis and have it classify any text we give it. The output of our classifier in this case is a dictionary in which the first element is the label and the second element is the score. Think of this as the confidence in this label. Try this out yourself with a variety of different input tests to see how this classifier works. While the pipeline comes with default settings, it's easy, super easy, to supply your own configurations. Here you can change things like the model, the pre- and post-processing settings, among dozens of other parameters. Start with the default and have fun experimenting. We'll use this pipeline function later in the video when we run our foundation and fine-tune models for inference. In addition to helping us build AI pipelines, Hugging Face makes it easy to train and fine-tune our models. We've seen that the Hugging Face pipeline gets our LLM ready to roll, but how do we actually teach it to be an expert in a specific task? That's where the Hugging Face trainer comes in. Imagine you're a coach with a talented athlete. They have the natural ability, but to reach their full potential, they need structured training, guidance on technique, and a way to track their progress. The Hugging Face trainer is like that coach for your LLM. Think of the trainer as the heart of your LLM training camp. Let's break down the key elements. The model. This is like your star athlete, the LLM you've chosen for your task. It's got raw potential, but needs refinement. the weights and hyperparameters. The weights are the model's parameters. That's what we're going to tweak to get the most out of the model. While the hyperparameters are settings like learning rate and batch size that control how the model learns. Dataset. This is the training ground. It contains examples of the specific task you want the model to master. For sentiment analysis, this might be a collection of movie reviews labeled as positive or negative. Train, test, and validate. The dataset is split into these three parts. The model learns from the train set, checks if it's improving using the validate set, and finally tests its newfound skills on the heretofore unseen test set. The trainer guides the LLM through the training data, adjusting the weights and hyperparameters to improve its performance on the task. It's like a coach refining the athlete's technique and strategy based on their performance and practice. As the model trains, the trainer keeps track of important metrics like accuracy, precision, recall, and F1 score. If you're unfamiliar with these metrics, then there's a link to a video explaining these in the description. These metrics tell us how well the model is doing and where it needs more work. We use the evaluate step to test the model's skills on unseen data from the test data set. This gives us an idea of how well it will perform in the real world. And finally, the predict step is where we use the fine-tuned model to make predictions on new data. This is like the athlete competing in a game after all their training. So there you have it. The Hugging Face Trainer takes the complexity out of training and fine-tuning, giving you a clear roadmap to customize your LLM to peak performance. Now, let's get down to business and see how we can apply this to real-world data. All right, we've got our tools ready, the Hugging Face pipeline and trainer. Now let's see them in action with some real code. Our mission, to take a pre-trained language model and see how well it performs on a simple sentiment recognition task, then teach it to understand movie reviews better and prove that our efforts make a real difference. Before we design our classes for this task, let's first review our requirements. We'll start with a pre-trained model. We'll use a version of the BERT transformer. We'll feed it with some movie review test data and see how it performs. In this case, we'll send it 25,000 movie reviews, and for this simple test, we'll see if it can correctly classify them as positive or negative. We'll compute our accuracy, precision, recall, and F1 scores for this model. Now, for just a moment, let's forget the test data and we'll use a trainer class on our model. We'll send it the training and validation data of some additional movie reviews to specialize it for this task. We've now transformed our pre-trained generalist semantic classifier into a specialist classifier for movie reviews. Once again, we'll run our predict method on the exact same movie review test data as we ran for our base model. This will give us the results of our fine-tuned model. We'd like to know if the time spent fine-tuning this model was worthwhile and compare the performance metrics of our fine-tuned model to that of our base BERT model. Do the accuracy, F1, precision, and recall scores improve and by enough to justify the additional expense of fine-tuning? So let's break these requirements down into some components that we can code. We'll need a few classes to implement this, and let's propose a design. Let's start with data processing. Some machines are more powerful than others. Some have access to powerful GPUs with lots of memory, while others don't. We'd like a class that not only tokenizes our data, but also allows us to make the dataset smaller for less powerful machines and larger for more capable ones. The Lucy data preprocessor does all of this. We initialize it with our dataset and tokenizer and send in some parameters to allow us to control the size of the datasets. We do this in our split datasets function. We can also use this class to help us draw a curve of accuracy versus dataset size. Generally speaking, the more training examples we have, the more accurate our fine-tuned model is likely to be. Next up is our Lucy Model Evaluator class. This is the performance analyst of our fine-tuning project. Its primary responsibility is to assess how well our sentiment analysis model is doing its job, both before and after fine-tuning. It accomplishes this by calculating the key performance metrics and, optionally, providing a more in-depth look at the model's predictions on specific examples. Along with the model, the init method takes a tokenizer to convert text into numerical tokens that the model can understand. It creates a data collator with padding object, which will help prepare batches of data for the model during evaluation. And it loads four metrics from the Hugging Face Evaluate library. Accuracy, the overall percentage of correct predictions. Precision, how many of the positive predictions were actually correct. Recall, how many of the actual positive cases were correctly identified. And F1, a balanced metric that combines both precision and recall. It defines a two-way mapping between numerical labels, 0 for negative sentiment and 1 for positive sentiment, and their corresponding text labels. The compute metrics method is the core of the evaluation process. It calculates the metrics mentioned above by comparing the model's predictions to the actual labels. The evaluate method computes metrics and provides some screen output to visualize the dataset and the performance of the base model. Next, we have the Lucy Model Trainer. This is a wrapper around the Hugging Face Trainer class that we looked at earlier on. It takes the model, tokenizer, and training data and fine-tunes our model for us. Finally, the Lucy Sentiment Analysis class is the orchestrator of our AI system. After initialization with the model, the dataset, and the sizes of each of the train, validation, and test sets, it evaluates our pre-trained model on the whole dataset, after showing a random sample of the test dataset on the screen. Then it fine-tunes the base model, evaluates the performance of this fine-tuned model relative to the base. Here's a full listing of the code. The main program creates a Lucy sentiment analysis object and runs through the methods that I just described to evaluate the base, fine-tune the base, and then evaluate the fine-tuned model. You'll see here that the starting values of the train, validation, and test sets are low, possibly far too low. But please, start with these values. With these values, you should see very little, if any, increase in performance of your fine-tuned model. But then, clearly depending upon the speed and memory of your GPU, increase the values by increments to assess the improvement in your fine-tuned model. With values of 5,000 training samples, 1,000 validation records, and a test set of 1,000 reviews, we can see that the baseline model got 7 of the initial random 10 review samples correctly classified. This gave it a precision, recall, and F1 score of 60%, 75%, and 66%. On the test set of 1,000, it achieved better performance with an accuracy of 88.1%. Precision and recall of 89.2 and 86.1 respectively, and an overall F1 score of 87.6%. Our fine-tuned model managed to beat this result with an accuracy of 89.2%, precision and recall of 88 and 90.2%, and an F1 score of 89.1%. And this is just after 2 epochs. After 5 epochs, the results improved, as you can see on the screen. Your results will vary due to the non-deterministic manner of token prediction by the LLM. Nevertheless, your results will be very close to these measures. As you increase the size of the training set, you'll see further improvement in the performance of the fine-tuned model. Here are some thoughts for some additional exercises. As per the second video, experimenting with putting a Gradio or Streamlit UI on this process to allow the user to change the baseline model as well as tweak the sizes of the train, validation, and test sets is a useful exercise in how to distribute your AI applications. This is a simple binary classification between positive and negative reviews, but why not look at a more complex sample, such as the full Yelp reviews dataset? This classifies a review into 1, 2, 3, 4, or 5 stars. A third option, pick a specific domain that interests you, like finance or sentiment on X, formerly known as Twitter. Find or create a dataset within that context. Finally, fine-tuning isn't just for sentiment analysis. Explore other tasks like text summarization, question answering, or even text generation. Think about creative ways you can use these fine-tuned models to solve problems or build new applications. So, let's recap what we've covered in this video. We explored how the Hugging Face pipeline simplifies the use of large language models, taking care of the nitty-gritty pre-processing and post-processing so that you can focus on your specific task. We saw how the Hugging Face trainer acts as your model's coach, guiding it to become an expert through fine-tuning on real-world data. And most importantly, we saw the tangible impact of fine-tuning on a sentiment analysis model, significantly improving the accuracy, precision, recall, and F1 score. Now it's your turn to experiment. Download the code. The full source code for this tutorial is available in a GitHub repo. Don't be afraid to tinker, tweak the parameters, and see how you can push the performance even further. Explore different tasks. Sentiment analysis is just the tip of the iceberg. Try applying what you've learned to other NLP tasks. Summarize text, answer questions, or even generate creative writing with your fine-tuned models. Join us in the next video. In our next video, we'll take fine-tuning to the next level with LoRA, a technique that can significantly speed up the process. Get ready to turbocharge your LLM training. Thanks for watching. If you enjoyed this video and got something from the code on GitHub, then please give the video a like. If you want to see more videos like this, then hit the notification bell and the subscribe button. Share this video with anyone you feel who may be interested. And for more deep dives into AI, consider becoming a member of the Lucidate YouTube channel. See you in the next video on LoRA Fine Tuning.